You know when you wake up from a nap and your entire body is just like warm? That's what I'm going through right now. And it's not bad, but I do still feel like I'm half asleep. So today I want to talk about Normal People by Sally Rooney. This book, she's short, but she packs a punch. A bit of context on my history with Normal People. I watched the show back in January, the show on Hulu, and I really enjoyed it. I thought it was really well done, and having both now watched the show and read the book, I think it's a very like accurate and very authentic adaptation. So I watched that, really loved that, and then I got the book maybe a couple months after, but I wanted to give some time between watching the show and reading the book so that I could kind of see it with fresh eyes. So I read the book last week. It only took me a few days. And I just have a lot of thoughts about it and a lot of emotions. It elicited both. And I need to just say it, and I need to just verbally process it a bit. And then maybe we can talk about it in the comments if any of y'all have also read it, since it's like very popular. I just wanna know other people's takes on what I'm sort of hung up on. If you're not familiar with Normal People, I have these two teenagers in Ireland named Marianne and Connell. They go to high school together. They are from a fairly small town, and Marianne's family is very wealthy, but for the most part, very loveless. It's a very cold atmosphere. And then Connell is raised by a single mother who works in Marianne's family's house as the maid. And so Marianne and Connell are kind of aware of each other. They see each other whenever Connell will pick up his mom from work, but beyond that, they don't really have much of a relationship. And in high school, Connell is very popular. He's very well liked, whereas Marianne is kind of seen as a social outcast. She's very, very intelligent, and she has no problem showing that she is intelligent to people in a way that it can at times be sort of abrasive and rude. And so that's kind of what prevents her a lot of times from building friendships. People already kind of dislike her, and then she isn't, you know, the most outwardly warm person. And Connell as well is very, very intelligent, but he is much more shy and reserved about his intelligence. One day, Connell is waiting for his mom to finish up work, and he and Marianne kiss. And from there, they start having this sexual relationship. It's very much just casual. After school, they will hang out, they'll sleep together, and then during school, though, they pretend as if nothing is happening. And that is largely by Connell's desire, because he worries that if people find out, then it'll be a big deal and it will ruin his friendships and all of that. And so from there, the book follows them over the course of maybe about 4 or 5 years, starting in their senior year of high school to then their whole life through university and then afterwards, and just a sort of like on again, off again relationship that they have. While their relationship is the central focus of the novel, they each are sort of going on their own personal journeys as well, and sort of trying to improve their own selves. And so for Marianne's case, that has to do with the types of friendships and other relationships she seeks out. And because her family is at best emotionally neglectful, at worst physically abusive, the other relationships that she seeks out are similarly toxic and similarly very unhealthy. And so it's about her learning to assert what she deserves in a relationship. And then it is also on Connell's end about him learning how to go into places where he's unfamiliar and where people don't know him and be comfortable, and kind of learning to trust in his own worth and his own value, that he belongs in these oftentimes very affluent and very elitist spaces. Just right off the bat, I really did love so much about this book. I gave it a 9.5 out of 10, like almost was a 10. The one thing that kind of kept me from giving it a 10 out of 10 was the final scene, which I'll talk about later, and I'll kind of warn y'all beforehand in case you haven't read it and don't want to be spoiled. First off, there are no quotation marks at all in this book. So anytime a character is speaking, you really only realize it when there's like the comma at the end of the sentence and then like the he says or she says. Whereas normally that can be very confusing, I think, and sometimes when I read books formatted in that way, I can't tell when someone is speaking or not until I get to those little phrases. I really was able to kind of keep with it very well, and I think that Rooney does a good job establishing both of their voices and establishing the rhythm well enough that even though you don't have that like visual cue of a quotation mark, you can still tell when it's a character speaking versus when it is their internal thoughts and emotions. In terms of like the formatting, basically each one is, so you'll have sort of like this, like 6 weeks later, and then it'll say April 2011. And so after each chapter, the start of the next one is like X amount of time later. And basically each chapter sort of focuses on this one central interaction that Marianne and Connell have with each other. But then within that chapter, within that interaction, they'll be reflecting on what has happened since the last chapter, both in terms of like them as a couple and also in terms of like their own personal lives. It covers so much time despite being just like 300 pages. It covers a lot of time and it covers a lot of growth in these characters' lives. And I think that the way that Sally Rooney describes their emotions and the way that they process both like happy events and like their love lives, but also the way that they process very traumatic events and very difficult moments is really well done. Both characters just feel very, very fleshed out. This is the sort of story that like you see it a lot where, you know, it's like the two people who are on again, off again, and no one can quite say what they want to say and they're not communicating well, and it can get really, really frustrating. But I think what makes this book like not fall into the same level of like annoyance that I often feel for those stories is that both of these characters clearly have other things going on in their lives besides their relationship. So it makes sense that they're not going to be as focused on like exploring their options beyond sleeping together, and that they're not always going to be the best at communicating and showing up for each other because they are dealing with a lot of other things that are either more immediate or just more more inflated in their minds as being deserving of their attention. You know, both characters are really, really likable. Even Marianne at the beginning, you're not sure like how likable she's going to be, but I think Rooney breaks down her walls in a really great way so that even though she kind of keeps this very, I don't want to say egotistical, but this very like high regard for herself, you see how that gets broken down. And another element that I really loved is how Marianne knows that she is smart and that she is so intelligent, but when you look at the relationships that she pursues outside of Connell, very often she's being degraded or she is being diminished and not appreciated or not valued. And I think that it was a really well done way of like sort of showing what she really thinks of herself and how even though she pretends to be this like very highly intelligent and, you know, effective and able person, she is also has a very low view of herself because of her home environment and because of how she was treated at school as well. Another thing that I think this book shows really well is how during these still very like developmental stages of these characters' lives, while they have romantic relationships and while those relationships are important to them, it shows how a lot of times these sort of personal struggles they are still working towards can infiltrate those relationships and really kind of cause them to self-destruct. She shows that not just through like Marianne and Connell's relationship, but also through, again, their other romantic relationships and their friendships as well. I think she does a good job at like showing a very holistic portrait of what growing up looks like and what finding out who you are and what you want to do with your life, how that doesn't just have to do with who you are in love with or who you're sleeping with, but it also has to do with your friends, your background, the field you want to pursue, how much money you have, all of these other factors that really color how you view yourself and how you view your options in life. So now I want to get to the one thing of the book that just I had trouble with. I don't know if it's me just remembering the show of it differently or if like maybe the show really does do a better job at kind of like highlighting this part of Marianne and Connell. Now I'm going to get into spoilers. I'm going to talk about the last scene because basically the whole book, you sort of have these two, besides their relationship, these two other character arcs happening between Connell finding his courage to go out and pursue unfamiliar environments and to make himself uncomfortable for the sake of his own growth. And then Marianne learning how to love herself and how to build a safe and stable environment that she can call home. And so in the final scene, when Connell gets into the New York creative writing program, and Marianne tells him to go, like, it does a good job showing how, like, okay, he took a risk in applying to this program and in even opening himself up to the option that he will move once again to somewhere even more unfamiliar across the ocean. However, what I have trouble with is that in that same scene, when Connell says that this other girl that he works with knew that he applied and Marianne didn't, and Marianne makes a comment about, like, oh, well, do you like her more than me, or, like, are you sleeping with her, something like that, it frustrated me so much, because just, like, the whole rest of that scene, Marianne is like, oh, I finally am secure in our love, I finally know that he is with me and that we are together and that we are strong and we are healthier. And so that moment just felt like such a step back and so contradictory to, like, the rest of her internal monologue, like, throughout that scene. And then again, at, like, the final, like, line is her basically saying that you should go, I'll always be here, you know that. It felt a little bit too, like, sure, you go out and pursue your dreams and I'll just stay here and chill out, and then when you're ready to come back, then you can come back and we'll just pick back up. Whereas I feel like in the show, they are more clear that the reason Marianne is staying is because she finally has a good job and a good, like, friendship group and a good home, and, like, she's finally in a place where she has built a safe space for herself that she does not want to leave, and so she is finally choosing her own health and her own needs over what someone else needs. And so I felt like it was just much better explained in the show. And then in the book, at the end, she kind of just goes back on that whole character arc, and so then it feels like Connell has a much more complete story happening, and Marianne is sort of just, like, stilted in a sense, because he never even asks her to come with him. It's never even, like, on the table. She never gets the option of saying, like, no, I'm going to stay while you go. She's just automatically assumes, like, oh, no, I'm not going, and he doesn't bring it up. It feels less like she is making a decision for herself and more that she's making one for him, and she's not even acknowledging her own reasons for wanting to stay. Like, she's acknowledging why going to New York will be good for Connell, but she's not acknowledging why staying in Dublin is good for her. And I just think that if she had included that, if there was a more direct mention of her choosing to stay because she knows that she needs to be in Dublin and that that is the place that she actively wants to go and that she isn't just letting things happen to her anymore, I just feel like her storyline would have felt more complete. If this is, like, the little storyline, Connell's, like, right here at the end and Marianne's, like, right here, like, just almost at the end, but just not quite. And so it just made it a little bit frustrating. And I had to, like, read and reread the last scene so many times just to, like, absorb all the dialogue and make sure that I was reading every single word. But that was really, like, my only gripe with the ending and the only thing that I'm still stuck on. So I'm curious if y'all have read it, or if you've watched the show, or if you just, like, know a lot about the story. What do y'all think? Do y'all feel as if Connell's ending is more complete and more thought out than Marianne's, or am I reading it completely different than you? Do you feel like they're both done? Do you feel like Connell has less of an ending than Marianne? I don't know. I'm just curious. Also, I'm reading Conversations with Friends right now, and I just got to a scene where she mentions a character named Marianne who has just been in New York, and she was visiting someone whose name was not Connell, and Conversations with Friends was released before Normal People, so it could very well not be intended to be the same character. But when I read that, I was like, oh my gosh, is Sally Rooney doing, like, a shared universe situation? Are all of these characters eventually going to meet? Imagine that. That would be really cool. I just wanted to talk about my thoughts on Normal People, get that off my chest, so to speak. If you like this video, you could like it. If you have a comment about this video, you could comment it. And if you just liked watching today, you could totally subscribe. I won't force you to, but, you know, that would be a cool thing that you can do to just, you know, help your mental health if it would do so. If you want to follow me on Instagram, on Goodreads, Twitter, all of that is linked below. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye.